So then, the then another study, the best-selling book, The Next 100 Years, by George Friedman. George Friedman is the author and founder of Stratcor. It's a very respected strategic forecasting company in the United States. Anu Sabin and George Friedman. In the first half of this century, the population passed, Islamic population passed, lumiin ang populasyon ng mga bansa. Ibinig ito na, Korea, Western Europe, Germany, Canada, United States, will create a major labor shortage in advanced industrial countries. Today, the more developed countries are very strict to pass on immigration. Mag-apply na rin immigration systems that are kaysa putas ng karayon. But later, according to Mr. Friedman, later in the first half of this century, and we are now already in the first half, 2010, 2020, the problem will be persuading them to come. Countries will go as far as to pay people to move their babayaran back. Yung mga taong nakapesto sa Pilipinas para mag-immigrate sa kanilang bansa. And right now, that is already happening. You see that, for example. If you have the right qualification, they are going to give you incentives para mag-immigrate sa New Zealand, even in Canada. Why? Kasi wala na sila tao, kulang sila ng tao. And later on, it will affect all forms of employment. They will have to do everything to induce Mexicans, isama natin ang Pinoy dyan, to come to the United States. They will be pinan ng Mexicano kung sila lagi ng tao. But in about 10, 15 years from now, they will have to open those walls and even bribe pay immigrants to go to them. Kaya, yung mga gusto mag-immigrate, yung mga anak nyo na gusto mag-immigrate, or maybe work in other countries later on, sila na ang mapakaawa sa atin, sila na ang pipila sa atin para mangin ang additional workers. So that, ladies and gentlemen, mga kanyusunan ko dali sa kagilan. Ang mga simple thoughts ko on protecting the right of the unborn and also fighting the productive gap. I spoke about the economy, I spoke about health, I spoke about population, I spoke about per capita income, population density. These are very relevant things in discussing reproductive health. Reproductive health is not a religious issue. Of course, it is to a lot of extent. But it is more than that. It is not about the church against the other people. The church is very important, siyempre. Laban sa religion natin, hindi mo pwede. Remember the cowboy? Bakit nag-revolt si Tagoy? Alam niyo yung history ng Tagoy? Kasi ayaw paspasan ng pare yung kanyang kapatid na namatay. Because I think namatay sa duel yung kapatid niya. Kaya nagalit si Tagoy because he felt this is why his religion was being violated by the Spaniards. Bakit meron mga gera sa ibang mundo? Kasi nababayulate yung religion niya. Religion is very important, but it's not only religion. But we debate all this, remember the things that I mentioned. It is about population, it is about employment, it is about gross domestic product, it is about health, it is about cancer, it is about protecting the right to get born, it is about what the Constitution provides that are also very important. So I hope, ladies and gentlemen, that I contributed something.